A very good morning to one and all for joining here. On behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, King's College of Engineering, I welcome you all for this national level one-day online workshop on planning and drafting of approval drawing. As a civil engineer, it is essential to be well-versed in planning and usage of drafting softwares. In general, offline workshops will attract more people since they can gain clear knowledge about the topic. But really, we are overwhelmed by the positive responses we have received from the external participants. More than 250 participants registered for this workshop, which increased our responsibilities to fulfill the expectation of the participants. But nowadays, we have adapted ourselves to the new normal, that is online mode of teaching learning. And we are succeeding in that virtual classes too. So we assure you that this e-workshop will also provide a platform for the participants to gain in-depth knowledge about approval drawings. With this introduction, I request Ms. V. Aishwarya, coordinator of this workshop, to welcome the gathering and also to introduce about the resource person. Thank you.
Very good morning to all. On behalf of Department of Civil Engineering, King's College of Engineering, I extend a warm welcome to our Honorable Secretary, beloved Principal and Vice Principal, our resource person and Head of Department of Civil Engineering, external participants from various educational institutions, industrialists, to this national level one-day online workshop on planning and drafting of approval drawings. Our resource person, Ms. Revathi, has completed UG Civil Engineering in Regional Engineering College, Trichy, which is now called as National Institute of Technology. She graduated her postgraduates It's in structural engineering in Sastra University, Tanjore. She presented 18 papers in national and international conference and published 8 papers in national and international journals. And she is also a life member of Indian Society of Technical Education. In addition to that, academic performance, she is very vast exposure in planning and construction also. We are very happy and honored to you as a have you as a resource person. With this introduction, I will hand over the session to our resource person. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Good morning to all. I welcome you all for the national level one-day online workshop on planning and drafting of approval drawing. As a civil engineer, we must know about planning and drafting of a building plan. For getting the building license, corporation issues building license to all type of building, such as special building and multi-story building, and for planning, the permission is issued by the by DTCP, that is Department of Town and Country Planning, and CMDA. Chennai Metropolitan Development Area, and by local planning authorities. The process differ not only from state to state, but it also varies from different cities. Next, in this workshop, drafting of approval drawing will be explained. Before that, one should know about the planning of the building. For preparing the plan, this bubble diagram will be useful to beginners for planning. And next, drafting of single line drawing by using grid sheets, and then detailed plan drawing will be explained after knowing some basic things. Okay, next. Before drafting the plan, before drafting the plan, we must know about some basic things, that is unit conversion, bylaws, room requirements, standard dimension, and technical terms. These 5 things will be helpful to draw the plan. Most of the countries are using the metric system in construction field, and all the measurements are in meter. In United States, still using the imperial system, and the units are measured in feet, inches, and pounds. in our country, we are using metric system in government sectors, that is in PWD highway department. They are using metric only for mass construction. In local areas, still we are using feet and inches. As a civil engineer, we must know about these two units. Now we see the unit conversion. In one feet, how many inches? 12 inches, right? Here, the inches are converted into feet. For calculating purpose, we have to know these 8 things. Mostly in site work, these 8 dimensions are used mainly for minor works, that is for window framing work, glass measurements and so on. Here, 9 inch divided by 12, we get 0.75 feet. Similarly, for 6 inches, 0.5 feet. For 3 inches, 0.25 feet. For 1.5 feet, 0.125 feet. Likewise, 4.5, 0.375 feet. 7.5, 0.675 feet. And 10.5, 0.75 feet. These we have to know. Next, here room dimensions are given, that the length L always the distance of x-axis. Okay, that is 10 feet 6 inches is the distance of x-axis, and breadth B is always in y-axis. The first one, 10 feet 6 inches, is the x-axis, and 11 feet 3 inches is the y-axis. I'm going to ask one question. Can you tell the total length of the length and breadth of the room? First, you tell the length of the room. Type your answer in chat box. You calculate the wall thickness 9 inches plus 10 feet 6 inches and 9 inches. How much? Can you tell the total length of the room?
12 feet.
Yeah, that's correct. Next, y-axis distance. Here I mentioned 9 inch means it is easy to you. If I give 4.5 means it's difficult to calculate the inches into feet. Okay. For y-axis, how much?
12.9
inch. That's correct. Some beginners will do what here 9 inches means they put the 0.9. If 10 feet 6 inches means 10.6 plus 0.9, 12.4 feet. It's not correct. We have to convert the inches into that is feet. That is, for inches, 9 is equal to 0.75. Plus 10 feet 6 inches means 10.5. So the length of the room is 12 feet. Here I have mentioned as it is. Okay, so it's first one is wrong, and we have to convert the inches to feet. The second one is the correct one. Here it's one simple room, so we can calculate manually. If distance is lengthy, means that time we have to use calculator for calculating purpose. So we have to know the know these conversions. Okay. Feet to meter. Up to 12 feet conversion from feet to meter is better while preparing approval drawing. Note the box here. 1 meter is equal to 3.28 feet. So 1 feet divided by 3.28 means we get 0.3 meter. Likewise, for inches, 9 inch equal to 0.75 by 3.28 equal to 0.23 meter. Or you can divide by 12 into 3.28. Okay, you can get the meter value. Likewise, up to 12, we have to know up to 12 feet conversions from meter to feet. Here I mentioned some bylaws for a built-up area. bylaws is the rules and regulation which formed by town planning authorities, and due to these bylaws each building will have proper lighting, air and ventilation. It ensures the opening space, room size, height of the building, area limitations and so on. This table shows the maximum permissible covered area for the plot. If the plot area is less than 200 meters square, the permissible built up area should be less than or equal to 66.67% of plot area. Similarly, above 200 to 500 meters square, the built up area should be 50% of the plot area or 133 meters square. Likewise, area of the plot from above 500 to 1000 meters square, the maximum permissible covered area should be 40% of the plot area or 250 meters square, whichever is small. Likewise, if the area of the plot is greater than 1000 meters square, permissible covered area is 33.33% or 400 meters square. Here, bylaws for plinth area. Height of the plinth, that is basement height, should not be less than 450 mm from the ground level. That is, it should not be less than 1.5 feet. If any drainage or other consideration, the plinth height will be increased up to 600 mm or more. Nowadays, house drainage are connected with municipal drainage. For leveling purpose, the plinth height will be increased. In water logging area, the minimum height of the plinth is 900 mm, that is 3 feet. Here, bylaws for ventilation. For lighting and air circulation, we must consider the ventilation for the building. In residential building, window area should not less than 1/10 of the floor area. For example, window area is 1.48 meter square. That is the length. Length and height is 1.22 into 1. That is 4 by 4 feet. Okay. In meter square, 1.48 square. For floor area is 9.3 meters square. 10 by 10 floor areas. 10 feet 10 by 10. In meter, 3.05 into 3.05 equal to 9.3 meters square. Here, see this one. 1.48 meter square is greater than 0.93 meter square, which is 1/10 of the floor area. So it's not lesser than 1/10 of the floor area. Likewise, bylaws for ventilation for institution, that is commercial building. In institution, classroom ventilation should not less than 1/5 of the floor area. And relaxation may be recommended for artificial ventilation. And for staircase, the ventilation per room should not be less than 1 meter square. Next, bylaws for floor area. In this table, types of room, minimum floor area and minimum size of the room length is given. For your clear idea, I have explained in this slide. That is, area of the living room is, here the living room is, minimum area is 9.5. So here I mentioned the living room is 9.5 meters square. And one of the length is 2.4 meter. What we have to, for getting the other side dimension, we have to divide the 9.5 by 2.4. We can get the value of the other side, that is 3.96 meter. It's a basic calculation only. Some students or beginners are struggling to calculate to get the length from the area. For that only I have explained here. Okay, next, see the previous slide. Here, a room, room, shop, floor, minimum floor area is 9 and one of the length is 2.4. Likewise, kitchen area, minimum area is 5 and it length is 1.8. Study room, store room, area is 3.6 and one side of the length is 1.8. Puja, bath and sing room, its minimum area is 1.8 and one of the length is 0.9. Portico, that is car porch, minimum area is 12 and one side of the length is 2.7. Here WC, wash, that is water closet, we say as the WC is the water closet, and washroom area is minimum area is 0.8 and the length is 0.9, and toilet minimum area is 2.9 and one of the length is 1.2. Here our room requirements are listed, kitchen, living room, dining room, bedroom, toilet, veranda and portico. Puja room is optional one, and then the above these rooms are essential. Puja room is the optional one, otherwise provision will be given to Puja involved. These requirements are depend upon the person. It may differ from person to person, and also it depends upon an availability of the plot area and financial constraint of the person. In this table, rooms and sizes of rooms are given. It's not mentioned a minimum or maximum dimension. It's sufficient for a single room. By using these dimension, we can planning for 1,000 square feet. Here I have mentioned the toilet, bathroom and water closet, and that is WC. WC means water closet. It may be Indian or Western type closet. Next, see the technical terms. Mostly well known these technical terms for all. Here the masonry foundation has mentioned them. In foundation, two type of constructions are going on. One is load bearing structure, that load the wall, carry all the loads to the foundation and then transfer to the soil. And the other one is framed structure. We construct by column and beam, and that column and beam only carry that load. In approval drawing, these technical terms are mentioned in sectional drawing. In this first stage is ground level, that one is the natural soil, and next one is the plinth level, and below the window we say is the sill level, that is the sill level is the bottom of the window, and lintel level, the sunshade is the outside of the slab, which is provided at the lintel level for protecting window from sunlight and rain water. Next, inside a loft is provided, that is 2 feet wide slab, which is provided inside at the lintel level for placing the storage material in the house. Finally, parapet. Next stage is roof level. Finally, parapet wall is provided at the open terrace. Next term, for planning a building, these practical things we have to know before planning. First we have to know the details from client, that we have to collect the details from client. First one is plot size, next built up area, and then room requirements of the house. It depends upon the client, that is a number of rooms needed for the client, and then phasing of the building, that is the direction of the building. These four things we have to know before designing the plan. Here I mentioned the planning and drafting. For planning and drafting, these following things must be known. That first one is plot size, second setbacks, next north direction, plinth area and room requirements, then standard dimension, aspects, joinery details, then bubble diagram, grid line formation, single line sketch, double line sketch. After knowing the above said, automatically we can do the planning and drafting of the building. Next term, usually the size of the plot is 40 feet by 60 feet, and its area is 2400 square feet. The one of the length is 40 feet, that is 12.19 meter, and another length is 60 feet. That is 18.29 meter. From this, the area is 2,400 square feet, and then in metric, 223 meters square. Here, see the setback. The setback means it's a minimum open spacing around the building. That is distance between a building and the boundary. See the front side opening is spacing is 10 feet, and then both side of the spacing is 5 feet, and the rear, that is back side, is 14.75 feet, more or less 15 feet. And in meter, front side spacing is 3 meter, and both side is 1.5 meter, and back side is 4.5 meter. Let we see the setback, how the setbacks have provided in roadside, rear side, and both side of the building. You can see this spacing, that is setback in both sides of the building. Next, in site plan, north direction should be mentioned upward. See the left side diagram. The road facing of the building towards west direction. Then north direction has mentioned towards left side of the building. See that north direction has mentioned towards left side of the building. It's not correct because we should not mention the north direction towards left side. In site plan, the north direction should be mentioned upward only. So we have see the right side one. So we have to rotate the total drawing, which shows the north direction towards upward. The right side of the site plan is correct one. Next, see the aspect. It is the positioning of the rooms in a building with respect to four directions, that is northeast, northeast, north, south, east, and west. In this table, left column shows the types of rooms and right column shows the suggested aspect. Aspect is the one of the good practice in planning of the building because it relates with scientifically. For example, see the kitchen. Suggested aspect is east and southeast. Suggested aspect for a kitchen is east and southeast. In morning time, the sunlight from east enter into the kitchen, which is wet, water draining area. Due to sunlight, it will automatically dry and free from bacteria. For a hygienic purpose, orient the kitchen in east side and toilet in west side is good. Better we will follow these aspect well. Following these aspect while preparing a building plan. Then next, see the joinery details. Here, three types of doors and three types of windows and one ventilator are listed. Dimensions are mentioned in feet as well as in meter. We see the main door. The main door is provided at the entrance of the building. All the furniture items are entered through the main door. So the width of the door is not less than 1 meter. That is 3 feet 3 inches. It should be a minimum 3 feet 3 inches. Here I mentioned 3 feet 6 inches. It's okay. Then door D1 is 3 feet width for other rooms, and door D2 is 2 feet 6 inches width for toilet door. For window, always size of the window on the here, the three type of windows are there. Always the sizes of windows depends upon the floor area of the room. For window, normally we provide 4 feet 6 inches by 4 feet 6 inches in living room, and 3 feet 6 inches by 4 feet 6 inches in rooms. And W2, that is window in kitchen, is 3 feet 6 inches by 3 feet 6 inches. See, compare with the other windows. Kitchen window height is lesser because the air from outside will turn off the stove. For this purpose, we reduce the height of the window. And the ventilator sizes of the ventilator is 3 feet by 2 feet or 2 feet by 1.5. It depends upon the floor area. Okay, let's we start the planning, planning the building. After getting the requirement from the client, we must orient the building rooms by means of bubble diagram. It will be useful for beginners. First step, mentioning the north direction. Here I have selected a north facing plot. So I have mentioned north direction towards down. And then second step, mentioning four direction by using a line. We have to mention the north, south, east, and west in four direction. Then only we can orient the rooms in proper aspect. Then naming the room inside the bubble diagram. And then in front side, we provide a veranda, a portico, and bedroom. And middle of the bubble diagram, living room, master room. And then backside is kitchen is marked. Kitchen is marked at the south side only. Similarly, we can roughly orient the building by using the bubble diagram. It will helpful for beginners. After completing the bubble diagram, we can start the single line diagram by using grid sheet. It may available in paper store or else we may use graph sheets. In this, each grid is 2 feet. If we want 10 by 10 feet, we can select 5 grid from this. Here I have shown for you. Kitchen is 10 by 10 feet. So I have selected 5 grid. Similarly, we can draw for room 10 by 10. Here length of the hall is 20 feet 9 meters, which included the wall thickness and that kitchen length is 10 feet and then room length is 10 feet. Plus we have to add the wall thickness. So totally all length is 20 feet 9 inches. This is the one of the methods for planning the house in single line by using grid sheet. Next, next I show you how to plan the building. If we want to plan for 900 square feet, means what we have to do. First, we draw one square 30 by 30, 30 feet by 30 feet, and then form the grid spacing of this 10 feet. I divide this square into vertically three part and then horizontally three. So I divide the square. I split up this square by nine square. It contains nine squares. What we have to do, we have to mention here that the length is here the length is 30 feet. Okay, so total square feet is 900. Total for square feet is 900. Here one side is 30 and another side is 30 feet. Okay, now you mentioned the room size inside. Here I provide veranda in front side and this facing of the plot is north. Okay, first we have to mention the direction. First, in front side veranda and next portico and then here room and then here another room. Okay, here kitchen and then here you can use this place as utility and then toilet. Okay, here. We consider this two square as all. Okay, this one is all. Okay. First of all, we have to the length is 30 feet. We have to deduct the wall from it. Okay, how many walls in this? Totally 9 walls. Sorry, totally 4 walls. Eh? The thickness of the wall is 9 inches. Here 4 9 inches. This one is 9 inches and this is 9 inches. Totally 9 plus 9, 1.5 feet. And then here 1 9 inches, 2 feet, 3 inches. And then here 1 9 inches. Totally 3 feet. We have to deduct this wall from 30 feet. So 30 feet length. 30 feet length minus 3 feet. That is thickness of the wall we have to deduct. How much the carpet area? That is the length of the carpet area? 27 feet. Here we having only 27 feet. So kitchen we can provide the length. Length of the kitchen is here 10 feet. Here 7 feet. And then here 10 feet. Afterwards, we can adjust it. First, we mentioned the length 10 plus 10, 20 plus 7, totally 27 feet. Okay. Next, see the another side. Here also the same one, 30 feet. We have to deduct all the walls. After deducting, the dimension is 27 feet. So here also 10 feet. For 27 feet, here 10 feet, and then here 10 feet, and then here 7 feet. What we have to do, we have to adjust the line. We want to increase the room size and the, if we want to increase the room or kitchen, we have to move these lines. Here you can move the spacing here. If you want here to, if you want here 12 feet means what we have to, we just move this wall. Okay, here you can, here you can reduce the dimension. This 5 feet, the distance is 5 feet, here 12 feet. So you can get the inner dimension of the room is 10 by 12. Likewise, you can move this line. Here, the width of the room is 10 feet. We want to increase means how to reduce the veranda space, then only you can increase the room size. Here 10 feet, I increase the length of the room is 12. 12 or 11, here I increase the room in 11. Increase the room by 11 feet, and then here how much? 6 feet. Okay, likewise we have to adjust. Now, now you can see the plan after adjustment of the wall. This one is the first one, and after adjustment, you can see the plan similar we have to draw for 1,000 square feet. for 1000 square feet, for 1200 square feet means what you have to do first. One of the length is 30 feet and another length is 40 feet. Okay. This one is the rectangle, 30 by 40. And the area of the square, the area of the building is 1200 square feet. What we have to, we split this one by using the line, we can split. Here we have in 12 squares. Likewise, we have to mention the rooms. Here, veranda, here, same as like previous one, here room. And then one bigger hall. And then this one is the master bedroom. And then yeah, this one is the attached toilet, this one is the common toilet, and then this one is the kitchen, and it may be, you can use this one as the utility, for utility purpose, can use this place. If you realize, yes, you have to draw. Okay, next. After completing the single line sketch, we can draw the plan with the wall thickness. This plan shows the interior design of the house. Okay, we can specify all the interiors. And then the following specification must be in drawing sheet. That is floor plan, elevation, section, site plan, then septic tank, borewell details, rainwater harvesting, staircase, foundation details, and title block. These septic tank borewells are same in all other drawings. It's a one-time preparation only. From septic tank to foundation, it's a one-time preparation only. In this. See the template. This diagram shows the approval drawing templates here. Plan, elevation, section, and site plan are changeable one. And this remaining are same for other drawing. Here we have to mention the details in title block. And then this is the approval drawing. Our plan must satisfy the client, then only we can start drafting of the approval drawing. Here, the scale is mentioned for the floor plan, elevation, section. The scale should not less than 1:100. For site plan, it should not less than 1:200. Septic tank, bore well, rainwater harvesting, staircase, foundation details. It's all are in not to scale. By using not to scale, we can prepare these things. Okay. We have to mention the in floor plan. In floor plan, we have to mention the specification usage of rooms, and then we have to mention the inner and outer dimensions. And if it a new building means, we have to mention the extension area in floor plan, as well as if existing means, we have to show it in floor plan. Then I have to mention the sizes of interior and exterior wall as well as partition, and width of opening of windows and doors. It will be specified in title block, and I have to mention the dimensions and directions of staircase in floor plan. This is the ground floor plan. In this plan, we have to mention the column as well as the room in inner dimensions and outer dimensions. Have to mention in this. For in elevation, we have to show the extension line of extension line and existing construction in elevation, and we have to show the shape of the roof, then floor floor shapes, everything we have to show in the elevations, and we have to mention the steps, front steps, staircase, and sunshade, and doors and window locations in front side of the building. The elevations, and then section details. And the scale of the section is, and the section scale should not less than 1:100. We have mentioned all the details of the foundation, wall, floors. Details should be mentioned in the sectional plan, and dimension also we have to mention in section. So the specifications are given. And then we have to mark the north directions, north direction in site plan. And then we have to mark the street locations, that is the road locations we have to mention. And then dimensions of plot as well as setback, we have to mention by using the dimension. And then we have to mention the septic tank, dispersion trench, borewell, and rainwater storage pits. In site plan, you see the septic tank and dispersion trench. Here, all the rainwaters are connected. Here, see the approval drawing. This approval drawing, we can first. We have to familiar in all commands in AutoCAD. We must familiar in all commands. Then only it is easy to complete the drawing. After opening the AutoCAD, first we have to save. First we have to save the file. After opening the approval drawing. After opening the AutoCAD, first you have to save the drawing. I save the drawing in low version. Here, the AutoCAD 2000 is given. In low version, you save this drawing. Then only you can see the. Then only you can see this this approval drawing in new version. See the plan. First, we draw the outline of the plan, and then draw all the walls by using offset commands. Then mark all the columns and fill it by using hatch and solid commands. Then trim the wall for providing doors and doors, and mark all the windows. Here, see the plan. First, what we have to do. We have to create one rectangle, which sizes one that is A3 size. We have to create the A3 size is 11 inches by 18 inches. That is 141 feet length, and width is 91 feet. After that, we have to create the plan. First, we draw the outline of the plan, and then draw all the walls by using as offset commands. After that, mark all the columns and fill it by using hatch or solid commands. And we have to trim the wall for providing doors, and mark all the windows in the wall, and then mention the ventilator. Similarly, we have to mention the all rooms and the inner dimension as well as the outer dimension. First, for dimension, first format the dimension here. Choose the dimension scale and create the new one. Here, type the feet and then continue. After that, select the primary units. Here, the unit format is architect, and then give OK. And create next one new, and create the metric one, and then continue. Here you have to metric and then continue. Here you have to mention the sunshade in dotted line. Here see the sunshade is in dotted line because the horizontal section of the plan at sea level. Here sunshade is provided at lintel level. So sunshade, staircase, portico slab, projections are in dotted line. Then mention the steps in both the front and back side, and also marking the direction of staircase. Next, see the elevation. It is a front view of the building. In front building, we can see the window, door, portico, column, and staircase. From steps and sunset, these things we have to mention in elevation. This line shows the basement level of the portico, and this line shows the steps of the staircase, and this one is the slope of the staircase, that is the back side of the staircase. We have to mention the slope like this only. We have to increase the spacing of the lines. For slope, we have to decrease the spacing of the line. This column is a circular one, so we have to mention by vertical lines. This line is the plinth line. Whatever things we have to see in this front side, we have to mention in elevation, and then we draw the sectional plan, which we have to project from the elevation. Here the section at AA is cut on the plan. Here the line cut at the window. See the line cut at the window. And here it cut the wall and arrows. The arrow shows the back side of the building. So we have to mention these windows, doors in section. This dimension mention the height of the building. See the section at AA. Here the section cut on the plan in left side, and right side it cut on the wall. And it cut the wall. And the arrow shows towards the back side of the building. So we have to mention these window, door, we have to mention these windows and door in section. See, here one window is in back side and one door is in back side. We have to mention these all things in section. And then in section we have to mention the height of the building. The basement is 1.5 feet, so here I mention in meter 0.46, and then height of the roof is 10 feet, that is 3.05 meters, and in thickness of the slab, roof slab is 4.5 inches, that is 1.11 meter, and then parapet is 2.5, here I mentioned 0.76 meter. These specifications we have to mention in the sections, that is parapet wall, weathering course, brick jelly, RCC slab, brick box, and floor mixing ratio. We have to mention all those things in this section. This one is the plinth beam, and this one is the lintel beam. All beams should be marked in this section. Here I mentioned the roof beam, and then see the difference between the left side window and right side window. Here the window is see the plan. Here the window cut on the window. So I mentioned this sunshade by filling the sunshade by hatch. Here I show the concrete. Okay. This one is elevation. We have to mention the ground level in section, and then after completing the plan, elevation and section, next we go to site plan. The site plan scale should not less than 1:200. Here what we have to do, first we draw the outline of the boundary line. Here the length of the plot is 56 feet and another length is 43 feet. After that we have to place the outline of the building here. Here I mentioned the setback, that is here 2.66 meter and 1.75 meter, and our front is 3.05 and the back side is 1.9. we have to mention all the setback here, and then we have to mention the RS numbers of this plot, and mentioning the outside dimension in plot as well as in building we have to mention, and then specifying the septic tank, dispersion trench, everything we have to shown in this plot site plan. Here see the rainwater, all rainwater should connect should be connected. The north face should be upward in upward direction in site plan. So I rotate the plan. See the septic tank plan and section of the septic tank and dispersion trench. You can draw this by using 1:2 scale, 1:200 scale, or in north to scale. Here I used 1:200 here. We have to mention the dimensions for my septic tank. We have to mention the outer dimensions of septic tank as well as the dispersion trench. And then this one is the ventilator shaft. We have to mention all those things, the dimensions and the specifications we have to mention in the mention for this in detail. And then rainwater storage pit, this pit size is 1 meter, that is 3 feet depth, and sizes of the length and breadth is also 3 feet. First what we have to do, first we have to fill the brick jelly, and then fill the sand filling. Above the sand fill we have to provide one RCC pole slab. It also not to scale. And then foundation detail, the sizes of the size of the foundation is 4 by 4 feet, that is 1.22 meter, and then depth of the foundation is 1.52 meter, that is 5 feet. Here I mentioned the sand filling as well as PCC. Sand filling is 9 inch depth, and PCC is PCC also 9 inches. Today we couldn't fill the sand filling up to 9 inches. Here we have to mention the ground level of the foundation. And to mention the ground level. After completing the foundation details, septic tank, and the rainwater, we have to draw the title. We have to space for the title block. We have to leave the space for title block. The distance of the title block is more or less. I provide 40 feet here. The sizes of the square is 141 feet, and then width is 91 feet, and then spacing of the title block is, that is the width of the title block is 40 feet. We have to leave some space for signing purpose. Here leave the space for engineer sign and for applicant sign, and we have to mention the site area as well as proposed area, and then we have to mention the notes, that is all dimensions. We have to mention all dimensions are in meters, and then these specifications we have to specific to for municipal purpose. We have to mention these notes in this. After that, we have to mention the area, that is total area of the plot we have to mention, and then we have to mention the proposed ground floor area, that is total floor area. This one is, that is 56 feet by 43 feet is 2408 feet, and in meter we have to multiply this 17 and 13, and the proposal ground floor is the built up area. We have to mention in this, the built up area is 1133 feet, and then meter is 105 meter. This opening spaces, and we have to deduct the ground floor area from the plot area, we can get the open space area, and then we have to mention the joinery details here, that MD is the main door, which is 1.7 meters, that is 3 feet 6 inches, and door D is 3 feet 0.91 is 3 meters, and door one is the toilet door, that is 2 feet 6 inches. We have reduced 6 inches from main door. Here the main door is, main door is main door width is 3 feet 6 inches, and other doors are 3 feet, and then toilet door is 2 feet 6 inches, and then height of the door is 7 feet. We have to mention all the dimensions in this title box. Here we have to leave some space for approval authorities. If it is not sufficient, means they will use in back side of the sheets, approval sheets. Here we have mentioned the title of the building, that is this plan showing the proposed constructions of the ground floor residential building at new RS number. This RS number we have to get from the documents, get from the document. We can take this RS number, and then division numbers, whatever it may be, you can get it. Here I showed this one for before submitting the before submitting the approval drawing, we have to mention the proposed construction area and then site area. I will show the principal drawing here. See, the this one is the blueprint. This is the blueprint. Before submitting, what we have to do, we have to color it. For proposed, we use red color for proposed area and then green color for site area. Okay. See this one. The scale is 1:400. In panchayat, it's a panchayat building, so I used 1:400 here. The outline is in green color and the inner dimension is in red color. Here you have to mention the proposed, that is, we have to mention the red color in ground floor plan, and also in elevation we have to mention the coloring. See the green color, the green color are in outside of the that is boundary line, we say is the site plan, and then green color is the building outline, and then we have to specify this color in septic tank and dispersion. Because it's a proposed one, so we have to mention in red color, and also we have to mention in a section also we have to mention. If it is existing, means we have to mention in yellow color. Here it is proposed, means I have shown in red color. Why we are doing this, means we have to separate the proposed as well as existing. For existing we have to mention in yellow color, for proposed we have to mention in red color. This is the interior plan. By practicing, we can perfect in everything. So practice these all things. Within three hours, we can finish this approval drawing, and we can charge for this minimum 3,000 rupees. So practice those things. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much for the presentation, ma'am. I hope the participants would have got a clear idea about approval drawing. So participants, if you have any queries, kindly post it in the chat box. We will share the mail ID too. You can send your queries in the shared mail ID. Actually, the workshop, I request Ms. V. Srividya, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, to deliver the vote of thanks.
On behalf of our organizing team from Department of Civil Engineering, it's my privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I express my gratitude to our resource person, Mrs. R. Revathi, for spending her precious time to grace this occasion and sharing the valuable concept of planning and drafting of approval drawing. We really owe you a lot, ma'am. I extend my humble thanks to all the external participants from various educational institutions and industrialists for your valuable support to conduct this workshop session. I would like to express my special thanks to our management, principal and vice principal for accepting this to conduct this workshop in a successful manner. The participants to the certificate through your mail. Thank you all.